Hello and welcome to the Cricket Digest channel. In this video, let's take a look at one of the controversial aspects of the game, the soft signal. For those who are not aware of this term, whenever there is a close catch has been taken and if the on-field umpires are not sure whether it's a clear catch or not, then they'll consult the TV umpire. During the consultation process, on-field umpires are told to inform the TV umpire about their first impression regarding the catch based on their observation. This on-field umpire's first impression is termed as a soft signal. Now, the TV umpire looks at all different camera footages from different angles to make his decision. If it is inconclusive from the footages whether or not the catch is clean, then the TV umpire sticks to the soft signal provided by the on-field umpire. Meaning, under inconclusive situations, if the soft signal is out, then the TV umpire stays with the out decision, and if the soft signal is not out, then the TV umpire stands with the not out decision. The biggest criticism is that if a TV umpire cannot make a decision conclusively after watching camera footages from different angles, then how is it possible for an on-field umpire to make his decision who watches the incident from a significant distance? A quite valid argument, isn't it? Now let's take a look at why the soft signal was introduced. The biggest problem with the technology used here is that the recorded video is a two-dimensional representation of the action happening in three-dimension. Hence, the concept of using video for examining the close catch is fundamentally flawed. To add to this theory, a few years back, Channel 9 of Australia had conducted an experiment on this with Tony Greig. Tony Greig was holding the ball in his hand as shown in the image. He was made to stand at the slip position and the cameras were made to record this. To everyone's surprise, though Tony Greig was holding the ball clearly in his hand, it looked like the ball is in touch with the ground. Many camera angles clearly suggested that the ball has touched the ground. The same experiment was conducted again by Channel 4 in England and the result was no different. Hence, it was concluded that these cameras more often than not show the clean catch as a grounded catch. With different broadcasters using different cameras, inconsistency factor involved in this was very high. Before the soft signal was introduced, there were a lot of incidents where the TV umpire could not decide conclusively and the benefit of the doubt was given in favor of the batsman. According to former international cricket umpire Simon Toffel, there had been a year when about 30 catches were referred to the third umpire without the soft signal and all had gone in favor of batsmen. By looking at this, ICC concluded that this was favoring the batsman and to bring the balance back, the soft signal was introduced. Though an on-field umpire cannot get a clear view of every catch, at least the decisions will not favor the batsman every time. I'm sure all the bowlers out there will agree with this concept. Do you feel any different? Do let us know in the comment section. Until next video, goodbye.